Okay, so the first part asks us to find G of 3. So pretty much what that's saying is find Y, find your output, if your input, your X, is 3. So here you'll see how it has an X, and instead of an X it has a 3. So that's how we know that we're trying to find out what Y is, and that the X is the 3. Okay, so we want to know what G of 3 is. So we're going to go to the x-axis, and we're going to go to 3, and we want to know what this point is right there. We want to know what the output is. So the ordered pair to this point is 3, 0. So if x is 3, then the y value is 0. So G of 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so the next question asks us to find the vertical intercept. So that means where does this graph, I'm going to make it pink, where does this graph right here, this pink graph, where does it cross the vertical axis? So the vertical axis, again, typically is the y-axis if we're using x and y. So we want to know where does this pink line cross this yellow axis here? So we could think of it as the y axis. Okay, so this line will cross this yellow y vertical axis right here. That point is 0, negative 1. So our vertical intercept is 0, negative 1. Okay, next we're asked to find the horizontal intercept. So here's the horizontal axis. So we want to know where does this pink graph here cross this yellow horizontal axis. So in other words, instead of horizontal axis, we could think of it as the x-axis since we're using x and y on this particular graph. Okay, so we want to know where does it cross this axis. So it crosses right here, and that point is 3, 0. So we would put 3, 0. Okay, this next question says, what is x? So we need to figure out what number, what is x? So what is x if y is 1? So we're finding out what input, in this case x, is going to get us an output, a y, of 1. So we're trying to find x. So here's our x-axis, and we want to know what x is going to have a y value of 1. So if we're thinking of an ordered pair, what ordered pair looks like this? So in other words, if the y, if the output is 1, I'm going to go to the y-axis right here. Here's the y-axis, and I'm going to look where the y is 1. So here is where y is 1 right here. Well, if we go across right here, this point right here, if I list this point right here, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's going to be 6, comma, 1. So that's the number that goes here. X is 6. The input is 6 when the output is 1. So the answer to this is 6. Find what x is if the y is 1. So if the x was 6, the y would be 1. So to answer the question, we would put 6. Okay, now we're asked to find the domain. So domain, we know, is what are all the possible x values for our function. So, since this is the x-axis, when we find the domain, we always go from the left to the right side. So if we look, the graph never goes on this side over here. The graph doesn't ever go over here. The most left point on this graph is right here. So the x value of that point right here is -4. So the graph starts on the left at -4, So again, this ordered pair right here is negative 4, negative 2. So since we're dealing with domain, domain is the x values. So that's why we're using negative 4. Okay, so it starts here at negative 4, and then the graph keeps going and going, and it just keeps going to the right. There's an arrow going infinitely to the right, so we're going to put infinity. And we always put parentheses around infinity. And the reason why we have a bracket here is because there's a solid dot, a solid point at negative 4 there. So we would put that our domain is negative 4 to infinity. Okay, lastly, we are asked to find the range. So let's make sure we review what range is. Range is just all the possible y values. So this time, we're looking at the y value. So here's the y-axis. And notice the y-axis, you can go up or down the y-axis. So when we're doing the range, we always go from least to greatest. So from the bottom to the top. So if we look at the bottom of this graph, there's no graph over here. The most bottom point is this point right here. There's no point on this graph that is below this point right here. This is the most bottom point. Well, this ordered pair of this point is negative 4, negative 2. Well, the range is the y value. So we're looking at this y value right here. So the y value is negative 2. So the graph starts at negative 2, and we're going to put a bracket around it here because there's a solid circle there. The most bottom point is a solid circle. Okay, so then as we go to the top, right, as we're going up on this graph, it just keeps going and going and going. So there's an arrow that's going upwards infinitely. So that is what we would put for our domain. Whoops. I'm sorry, that's what we would put for our range.